apparently a royal baby exists. Yeah, I just want to say, don't be fooled by this tiny, adorable, oh my God, it's so adorable, royal baby. The fuck was I saying? Oh yeah, this baby is a con designed to keep you supporting an antiquated, nepotistic, neatly dressed system of governance, the monarchy. Right now, we've got Elizabeth, and while I would fully support having baby George as our head of state, he's still three assassinations away. I'm telling you, one more gnarly European heatwave and Charles is gonna end up king. Now, I have seen enough Who Killed Diana documentaries to know that Charles can't be trusted. Also, apparently he doesn't even wanna be king. And if unnamed royal sources aren't enough for you, how about the former Prime Minister of Australia who says that Charles supports a republic? I mean, would Paul Keating say any old thing unprompted and with no tangible evidence because he's got nothing to lose and wants to bolster a cause he's been pushing for the last few decades? Exactly. So maybe now is the time to become a republic. And I say this as someone who owns a Harry and Meghan commemorative mug and a Will and Kate commemorative mug and a Charles and Diana commemorative mug, RIP. I also quite like the Queen. She happens to be the only white person who can wear yellow. I like Fergie, I like Fergie's kids, I like Fergie's kids' vag hats, I like Fergie's ex-husband, whoever he is. I like the corgis, RIP. I like, oh. Take or leave him, eh? Point being, I like the royal family. But remember when Scott Ludlam kicked off a national parliamentary hemorrhage because one time he glanced at New Zealand from an airplane and didn't officially renounce it? Jesus Christ, we were gonna make Josh Frydenberg prove he didn't have allegiance to Hungary, the country that left his family stateless during the Second World War. That's how much of a problem we had with our parliamentarians even being related by blood to someone who wasn't remotely from here. Meanwhile, the person right at the very top, British, like fully British. Like we've been marrying our cousins, British. Nah, mate, let's do it. Let's just become a republic, it'll be fun. We'll get a new flag, we'll finally get rid of that fucking girt line in our national effort. Who says girt? And we can forge a new identity as a country with an Indigenous history, a British past, and a multicultural future. You're thinking about it. I know it doesn't seem that way because everyone's excited over Captain Adorabalus over here, but now is as good a time as any.